Okay, so, we see, we have our x2 of t function here, our x1 of t function here. Okay, and we want to know when the positions are the same. Well, that's going to be exactly where the two graphs cross. So we can see it graphically. We could even estimate, if I've drawn this correctly, and I might have drawn it reasonably well, but we're not going to take this one to the bank. We see that sometime a little less than 4 seconds maybe is where they collide, or where they have the same position. Maybe a little more than 3 seconds, between 3 and 4 seconds. I don't know. I haven't worked it out. Okay. So, the same position then occurs when x1 of t equals x2 of t. This is a simple equation that we can solve for t. Now, what kind of equation is it? Well, let's write it out. Here's our x1 of t, so I write that here. Here's our x2 of t function. I put that on the other side with an equal sign. And now I have an equation that I want to solve for t. Well, first thing we notice about this equation is, better be, it's a quadratic equation. Now, as it will turn out, in this specific instance, we don't really need to use the techniques for quadratic equations in order to solve it, but usually we will, so I'm going to write it out that way first. So we put this into the standard form of a quadratic equation where the one side is zero. The other side has something times t squared and something times t and then some other term, constant term. And you're generally going to have to solve this by the quadratic formula. Now, if you want to try to complete the square and all this stuff, that works, but it's unnecessary. It's perfectly okay to do away with a lot of the machinery we use in developing quadratic equations in pre-calculus and algebra, and just use the quadratic formula. Those other things come into play in some cases, completing the square and so forth. We're not going to worry about that right now. It's not necessary. We just want to solve this equation. Now, it turns out we don't really need the quadratic formula here because we don't have a multiple of just t. But I'm going to write it out anyway. We would write out t equals negative 0 plus or minus 0 squared minus 4 times the coefficient of t squared times the constant term here divided by 2 times the coefficient of t squared. So review the quadratic formula. One confusion with the quadratic formula, between the quadratic formula and this, is we use a for acceleration. But when we get our position function, the coefficient of t squared is 1/2 a. But that's the quantity that we use with the with the usual form of the quadratic formula. So we've got to be careful about that. So just be on your guard. Okay, well, we don't really have to do that, but we could. It'd be easy enough to do this substitution and work it out. And I actually recommend that you do if you've got a few minutes. It shouldn't take long. But in this case, we don't have any first power of t in this equation. So we can just rearrange it to this. We can divide by the 10.8 centimeters per second squared. That'll give us t squared. And then the solution to t squared equals whatever is t equals plus or minus the square root of that whatever. So it's going to be plus or minus the square root of this. And I'm asking you to solve this for homework. So we plug that into our x1 of t and x2 of t. And that'll tell us where they meet, the position at which they meet. And if you're asked for the velocities, we can plug that into our v1 and v2 functions and find the two velocities when they meet. So that if they happen to be on the same track, of course, you've got two different tracks with two different slopes in this case, so you don't. But if you have two objects moving along the same track, that's going to be the two velocities they have when they collide. And you'll be able to figure out the relative velocity and all kinds of other stuff. Okay, well, this is all, I think, pretty neat. Try to tie it together as best you can. You want to within a week or so, have it tied together very, very well, and completely understand this scheme, because if you do, the problems that you're going to have to solve from your textbook are going to be much easier.